This is Rob Polly. He collects old Bob Dylan records and loves hanging out with his kids and strumming his 1963 Gibson guitar. Rob leads a team of emerging technology security experts at Microsoft.
I've been here at Microsoft almost 17 years now. This role that I have is unlike any others. I have to be honest with you, I think there's probably only three teams like mine, maybe, in the world. Haven't run across too many so far, but we get to work with the latest and greatest innovation that's happening. The second thing that we get to do is we actually get to kind of help deploy that work into our own company and see the results that it bears there. We work very closely with all levels of our engineering teams, from vice presidents to the chief technical officers, all the way down to individual feature teams, kind of helping them understand the perspective of the enterprise. And then lastly, probably like the one part that I find to be really the most rewarding is I get to be the trusted advisor to the Fortune 100. And because they come and ask, how did you do it? And we get this great discussion going about why we've made certain choices, what could they do to help their environment? And they inform us as well about things that they do much better than we do. So it's really, really a rewarding experience. The things that you need to do to, like the requirements that you have to meet, whether they're regulatory or internal governance processes, those aren't different, but how you go about it has changed. Before we had security gates. So every time we needed to go through, someone wanted to go deploy something in a data center or have a new server racked, I mean, there's a bunch of check items. So you'd have to go through like, okay, procurement, great. You know, they look through it. Did you have the security check on that? Great. Let's go put it in this environment. Great. Let's, before we go into put it into production, it's challenging because all of these processes that you've built up for the past 20 years, they're no longer relevant.
The speed of business innovation is quicker by the day, and central IT can no longer use a linear model to support security. The team needed to find ways to take advantage of new capabilities and rethink how security could become part of a system with distributed roles and responsibilities.
You got to understand that the environment is infinitely more complex than what it was. At the Enterprise Cloud Security Party today, there are three main factions. You have your cloud service providers, central IT team, of course, and then you've got this other party, which is your app team or your IT service or your DevOps teams. As you look at security, you've got to get used to this model of saying, well, I'm responsible for part of it. The cloud service provider is going to be responsible for a whole bunch. With Azure and even Office 365, to some extent, I mean, we've really taken a different approach than we have in the past. We've really, I don't want to say we've treated it as an adversary, but I would say that we've tried to do our best to run it like we were a customer. They kind of have this equation, and it's enterprise cloud security is the sum of a few parts. One is, how do you feel about the cloud service provider's platform and its capabilities? Do they have the capabilities that you need? How do you feel about the services that sit on top of that? Do they have the security stance that you need? Do they provide the ability for you to get the information out of it that you want? Do they help your organization innovate? Are they ready for you to use? And I think if you're moving to something like a SaaS provider, like an Office 365, maybe you combine the platform and the services together. Now we can have a real security discussion about how you do the verification process or what risks or concerns do you have about it. So you try to help people navigate by using their common language, ITIL, the International Standards Organization. The things that Microsoft uses as we talk about it with our cloud, especially with customers, we really use independently verified third-party certifications like ISO 27001, or maybe it's going through FedRAMP with the government. We build and we deliver and operate these services in a certified manner. And so fundamentally, if you're an enterprise customer, anything like us that has 20 years of legacy data center presence and understanding how that's different and how that works and doesn't work in the cloud is really an essential part. Before it was just central IT, they owned all the rules in the game, had all the gates, to now that sits in completely someone else's data center where I don't even have the ability to go and check on the servers myself and have access to it. Those are mind-blowing concepts for anybody that has any history in security. Think about your governance and policies, and kind of what are the standards, the policies, what frameworks do you use to make sure that auditors can understand what's expected of them? Then you've got to have a whole layer of central IT capabilities, which the process, the people, the technology, you have to understand how all of that folds in. It's about how you share information and what information can be used, how information workers need to behave. Like, how am I allowed to share? How do I have to classify? For some people, it's a little bit of a culture shock, is that you actually have to give up a little bit of control in order to get more control. I have to take my hands off the wheel in order to actually let someone else steer, because they're actually more efficient at doing it than I am. It's just about knowing everything about your environment, who has access to what and when, being able to tag it with like the criticality so that you can actually get an event and have the context. The last key ingredient is how do I enable my app teams and my IT service teams and my DevOps teams, how do I give them the tools and the guidance and the capability that they need to really be our first eyes and ears, our responders, how to do it right, how to monitor it right, how to know when they're in over their heads. There's a couple of great tools that we use from Azure itself. Just to take a step back, if you thought about the things that really are important that teams have control over, the 80% to 90% of things that if you absolutely just did these, you would deal with most of the silliness that you get yourself into, taking care of like patching and vulnerabilities and responding, like configuration, like turning on encryption. These are just the basics. And if you do the security basics, you've tackled a bunch of stuff. And the other stuff is just weird anomalies, the advanced persistent threat that occurs, that why you rely upon the cloud and your central IT organization to figure all this stuff out for you.
While there are several components that define cloud security, many parts rely on implementation by DevOps teams. Microsoft engineers have developed a secure DevOps kit for Azure to save time and money, increase cloud security awareness, and create a simpler, more structured, and consistent security environment in our IT Azure app infrastructure. Microsoft is now sharing this secure DevOps kit with customers, so you can have access to these best practices and helpful tools for building and working securely in the cloud, including automation, extensions, plugins, templates, modules, and more. The tools are organized into 6 main categories. The subscription security component is a package of scripts and programs to help ensure secure provisioning, configuration, and administration of an Azure subscription. The health check script, provisioning script, and other tools will help you set up a compliant, secure subscription right from the start, so you can have a solid foundation and check your settings for compliance along the way. The secure development components will help you make sure security is integrated into the day-to-day development process by providing security verification tests to verify built-in security controls for common services, and security IntelliSense to offer secure coding guidelines and corrections. The build release tasks for continuous integration and continuous deployment will let you check subscription and resource security during automated build and deployment. The continuance assurance tool helps you stay current with Azure security feature improvements to keep the state of your security from drifting. It also encourages adherence to security best practices such as key rotation and separation of duties. A central dashboard for alerting and monitoring will let you view reports on the state of their security and trends for their Azure subscriptions and applications. The Operations Management Suite dashboard builds all the necessary components needed for security state monitoring. The Secure DevOps Kit generates telemetry events from all stages that use automation, scripts, or extensions. The telemetry supports a data-driven approach to agile development and DevOps, by allowing you to make measured and accurate security improvement decisions in a continuous fashion. The Secure DevOps Kit was designed by engineers working in the cloud to simplify security checks and compliance, and to put the latest security best practices and tools at your fingertips.
Azure Security Center really helps our DevOps teams optimize their specific IT environment and puts them in a position to be able to establish policy, to be able to identify someone as a security contact, so you establish the ownership of the role and the competency And then you get all of this amazing insight. Oh, by the way, did you know that this RDP port was open and that you've had a bunch of failed attempts, someone trying to hit this port? And that gives you like really specific and actionable recommendations to go along with it that really puts a lot of power in the hands of someone who's not a security person. And I think that's the whole key to making your DevOps organization a success in your enterprise. I think we can make the argument that one actually could be much safer in the cloud than they could on-premise. I think fundamentally one of the reasons would be that there's way too many bad guys out there and not enough good guys. If you're the only good guy fighting for you inside your moat defending your castle, that's not gonna work. There's too many bad guys, too many threats, too many things out there. So let a cloud service provider who's got purview over hundreds or thousands or tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands or millions of customers and all of that event information coming in, let them do a bunch of that recon for you, because it's so hard to keep up with advanced persistent threat. I think we collect some crazy amount of like 10 billion events a day from Windows machines that are on premise. It's like 10 billion pieces of hay, looking for just a couple of silver needles in each of them. So one of the things that we're really driving to with Azure, what we get is we actually get the needles, because they provide all of that back to us through data lakes and machine learning, and there's a bunch of goodness there. I can know who has access to what at any time. I can use a graph to actually pull together all of the information that I need to determine what happened, what transpired, who was affected by it, and what else may occur. OMS itself is over 30 solutions that help you manage everything from like best practices for your server deployment, best practices for your AD environment, monitoring your Key Vault implementation, doing log analytics and helping you secure that, doing like configuration of baselines for your operating systems, and so many, many more things based upon all this log information that's available. But the cloud actually gives you so much more than what you actually ever have on-prem, because the one thing that I know to be true is that I get billed for everything that I use. And if I get billed for everything that I use, now I understand everything that I have. And if you can just start from that, I mean, that's the most fundamental thing about security, is knowing what your attack surface is. And as soon as you can understand that, now you've got something really, really powerful from which to build vulnerability management, patch management, configuration management, policy. As a member of, a longtime member of Microsoft IT, especially in today's world, I will honestly say that it's our duty, not only to the company, but to anybody else who wants to do this, to kind of share our experiences. For me, it's a bit of an honor to actually do it. It's really cool that not only get to do it, but I actually enjoy being like the trusted advisor. Working on the cloud is so much fun. I can't believe all of the challenges that you get to face every day. And for me, having those challenges and those problems and those opportunities, I mean, that's why we work here at Microsoft, is to solve the biggest, toughest challenges.
In our 10-part video series, Expedition Cloud, Brad Wright and other Microsoft technical experts will share the inside story of Microsoft's journey to the cloud, including proven practices, things we do differently, and advice for customers on the same journey towards digital transformation.